वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स आई होप यू आर फाइन यू आर बिजी विथ योर प्रिपरेशन फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस ऑल द क्वेश्चंस फॉर द ग्रामर रिवीजन द लास्ट क्वेश्चंस is here on the board as you can see on the board question number 3b fill in the blanks with appropriate preposition my dear students we have learned all the prepositions okay even we have solved all the exercises of the preposition earlier but now here we will solve this question by seeing the picture will be there on the board here you will see the picture see the pictures and whatever the prepositions are given in the brackets as you can see on the board just use those prepositions and try to fill correct preposition in these blanks okay in these blanks I hope you can get each answer from these pictures and you will write correct answer for these blanks okay so dear students let's see the picture very carefully before we see the picture just read the prepositions what is the given the bracket you can say under in between on behind near in front of these are the prepositions here if you see the picture very carefully you will see whatever is given in the picture here it's written okay all the sentences if you see the picture and if you read the sentence easily you will get answer dear students So dear students, let's see the picture. What you can see in the picture? You can see in the picture there is a table. If you see in the picture there is a cage. If you see the picture very carefully, you will find parrot, one woman, sofa, umbrella. Picture on the wall. There is a table. Okay, door, dog and cat. As you can see in the picture, so dear students, now let's try to solve these blanks. Okay, so as you can see in the picture, dear students, let's the first sentence. Okay, there is a parrot. That's the cage. Okay, there is a parrot. There is a parrot. That's the cage. So my dear students, now here you can see in the picture. Where is the parrot? If you see the parrot is in the cage. What is your answer? The parrot is in the cage. So here the answer will be the parrot is in the cage. There is a parrot in the cage. As you can see, dear students, the parrot is in the cage. Now, if you see the second sentence, the ball is against the table. Dear students, can you find the ball? Where is the ball? If you see the table and below the table, under the table there is a ball. So which preposition for the ball? So what will you say in the bracket? From the bracket, what will you get? You will get under. There is a ball. Okay, under the table. Or you can write the ball is under the table. So here the answer will be under. The ball is under the table. The ball is under the table. Next, dear students, if you see the third sentence, the woman is past the dog and the cat. So my dear students, can you see the woman? The woman is standing. The woman is standing. If you see, there is a dog also and cat also. So what preposition will you choose and there is an object. Okay. Behind, what do you call? Beside there is a one object and here also. Okay. So that is one between. So the woman is between the dog and the cat. So third answer between. The woman is between the dog and the cat. That's the third answer. Next, if you see the fourth number, same woman. The woman is that's the sofa. Yes, friends, can you see the sofa? And if you see the woman, how will you say? What can you say? Can you say behind, near, or in front of? What will you say? The woman is in front of sofa. The woman is in front of the sofa. In front of. The woman is in front of the sofa. So you can say the woman is standing in front of the sofa. The woman is standing between the dog and the cat. Okay? Let's see the 20 students. The pictures are best. The wall. So dear students, if you see the pictures, where are the pictures in the room? Okay, so you will see that pictures are on the wall. The pictures are on the wall. So here the answer will be on the wall. The pictures are on the wall. Next, sixth number, the table is best, the door. Can you see dear students, the table and door. So which preposition will you use? What is that? Now, near the table, okay? It means the table is near the door. The table is near the door, okay? Next, seventh, the umbrella is there, the sofa. So, dear students, if you see the sofa, and then someone read umbrella, can you see the sofa and umbrella? What will you use? Which preposition will you use? So, dear students, now what is that here? Behind. If you see very carefully, the umbrella is lying behind the sofa. So your answer is behind. Okay, the umbrella is behind the sofa. So my dear students, if you see the picture very carefully, you will use preposition in correct way. So dear students, this is the question in a new way. Now, let's see one more question like this. Picture will be given. See the picture very carefully and try to fill in the blanks with correct preposition, with appropriate preposition. So, dear students, let's see one more question like this. And I hope, dear students, you will get all these blanks. Okay? And you will understand this exercise also, this question also. Let's see one more question for the preposition. So, dear students, let's have one more exercise, or you can say question. Third week, fill in the blanks with appropriate preposition. So, dear students, here also, the picture will be given. Look at the picture very carefully. And try to fill in the blanks. Whatever the sentences are given here, just fill correct answer in these sentences. So, dear students, here you can see your picture. If you see the picture very carefully, what can you see in the picture? So, my dear students, if you see the picture carefully, you will find there is a boy, pillow, bed, dog, rug. Can you see the rug where the dog is? Okay. If you see, there is a lamp in the room. If you see, dear students, you will find a table. You will find a window curtain. Yes? No. I hope you will find all these things in this picture. So, my dear students, now just look at the picture very carefully and try to give answers of these blanks. You can see the six blanks. If you see the six blanks, okay? So if you see the picture very carefully, you will find a boy. The boy, okay? Where is the boy? What will you say? Where is the boy? Where is the boy sitting? Where is the boy sitting? So what will you say? The boy is sitting in the bed or on the bed? What will you say, dear students? Okay, the boy is sitting. That's the bed. What will you say? On? Yeah, in. What will you say? The boy is sitting on the bed. Answer is the boy is sitting on the bed. And dear students, here I didn't give brackets. If you see the picture, you will find only picture, but no brackets. Just see the picture very carefully and try to use preposition, whatever correct preposition for the each blank. Okay? So the boy is sitting on the bed. If you find. Next sentence is here. The pillow is next the bed. What can you say? The pillow is in the bed or on the bed? On the bed. On the head, like that. Okay? So here what will you say? The pillow is in the bed or on the bed? So what will you say to the students? You will say the pillow is on the bed. Okay? On. It's not a in. Please, you can't say in the bed. You can say on the bed. The pillow is on the bed. Next, my dear students, if you find the third of the sentence, if you see the third, you can say the third sentence, the lamp is next the window curtain. Dear students, if you see the picture, there is a table, okay, there is a window curtain, and here lamp is also. So what can you say? The lamp is next the window curtain. So what will you say? Will you say behind or will you say in front of? Now what I am doing? I am standing in front of you. Okay? Through this offline video. So you can see in front of. So the lamp is in front of the window curtain. Okay? So here you will write in front of. Please try to get it. The lamp is in front of the window curtain. Okay? Next, dear students, if you find the dog in the room, where is the dog? Where do you find the dog? Can you see there is a one kind of rug? Okay, that is called rug. Mat, what do you call rug? The dog is on the rug. The dog is on the rug. You can't say the dog is in the rug. The dog is on the rug. On. The dog is on the rug. That's a phone number if you see the picture. Next, my dear students, here fifth one. The table is next the floor. Can you see the table is next the floor? So you can say the table is on the floor. The table is on the floor. The table is on the floor. My dear students, now this sentence, it can be twisted also. If I change here the object, can you see the table is on the floor? But instead of this floor, if I write another, if you see the picture very carefully, the table is that's the window. That's the window. So what we use? So here that time the preposition will be changed. The table is near the window. What will you say? The table is near the window. So dear students, just see the picture very carefully and try to fill in the blanks. Okay, so here the table is okay on the floor. The table is on the floor. The table is on the floor. Next, here you can see the lamp is next the table. The lamp is next the table. Can you see, my dear students? The lamp is next the table. So if you find the lamp is on the table, so here the answer is the lamp is on the table. So dear students, here in this question, what you will get one preposition, it is used most of the time. Or, if you see the boy is sitting on the bed, the pillow is on the bed, okay, on, it shows place, on, it is a preposition, it shows place, the lamp is in front of the window curtain, the lamp is in front of the window curtain. Okay. The dog is next on the rug. If you see the picture, the dog is on the rug. shows place. The table is on the floor, the lamp is on the table. Okay, so like this, blanks will be asked if question can be asked also. Okay, but just look at the picture very carefully, whatever the picture is given, and try to fill in the blanks and try to give the answer. So, dear students, I hope you will understand this kind of exercise. Okay, and dear students, now it can be asked another extra question of picture in the worksheet. Okay, I saw here two pictures for the preposition, but it can be asked one more picture, three pictures for the filling of blanks. Just look at the picture very carefully and fill in the blanks. I hope you will understand. So, dear students, now here the grammar revision is finished. So, see you. Bye.